Hey, you guys. Let's do another Sheriff's Blotter. I hear some bubble gum I'm chewing, by the way. Super bubble. Bubble gum. Okay. And this. This is the Sheriff's Blotter dated May 26th. Okay. May 12th. A 26-year-old man received a citation in the 500 block of such and such a road for being under the influence of a controlled substance. May 13th. Authorities discovered and removed a credit card skimmer at the Chase Bank in the 400 block of such and such. A 34-year-old man was stopped and arrested by police in the 100 block of such and such after driving with an open container, driving on a suspended license, being under the influence of a controlled substance, and possession of drug paraphernalia. Oh my goodness. May 14th, a 33-year-old man found too intoxicated to care for himself in the 1200 block of South such and such street was taken to jail. May 15th, police cited a 21-year-old woman in the 500 block of North such and such street for possession of concentrated cannabis and driving with marijuana. Police were called to the 200 block of such and such after receiving word that a 25-year-old woman was in the act of committing spousal battery. A 40-year-old man was arrested in the 1500 block of West such and such road for being under the influence of methamphetamine and possession of a controlled substance and drug paraphernalia. May 16th, a 31-year-old man was found in the 500 block of East such and such drive was under the influence of a controlled substance, and he was subsequently arrested and also charged with possession of meth. May 17th, a man, age 30, was arrested in the 500 block of North such and such road for being under the influence of a controlled substance. May 18th, a 23-year-old man was cited in the 500 block of such and such for being under the influence of a controlled substance. May 19th, police arrested a 21-year-old man and the 4100 block of such and such a drive for being under the influence of a controlled substance and possession of drug for sale. That same day, later that day, on May 19th, two men, age 21 and 22, were arrested in the 1300 block of that same road for being under the influence of a controlled substance, possession of a controlled substance, and drug paraphernalia. May 12th, four thieves stole more than $1,000 worth of merchandise from the wine store in the 300 block of such and such. May 13th, police arrested a 24-year-old man near the intersection of such and such street for possession of methamphetamine accessories, and as well for being under the influence a 23-year-old woman with him who cited for lesser drug-related crime and activity. A 26-year-old man was arrested in a 1400 block of East such and such after he elbowed someone in the throat and in the eye and in the ear during an argument. The Little League snack bar in the 1300 block of such and such was broken into by burglars who stole up to $1,000 worth of items. May 14th, police arrested a 39-year-old woman and a 37-year-old man for domestic battery of one another and for being under the influence of a controlled substance. The man admitted to tapping his girlfriend after she tapped him first. Tapping? What does he mean, tapping? Oh my goodness. A 35-year-old man was arrested for inflicting corporal injury on his spouse or cohabitant in the 900 block of such and such. May 15th, a 27-year-old woman violated her probation by being under the influence of a controlled substance in the 2900 block of such and such. May 16th, a woman, age 58, was arrested an 1100 block of such and such after punching her boyfriend of 23 years in the nose and in his ear. Police arrested a 40-year-old man in the 2600 block of such and such for battering his girlfriend and bruising her arm. May 18th. May 18th. Police issued citations to two women. May 18th, police issued citations to two women, age 23 and age 51, in the 100 block of such and such a road for being under the influence of a controlled substance. The 23-year-old was also cited for possession of drug paraphernalia, with the woman was a 41-year-old man who was also arrested for unlawful possession of a firearm and controlled substance, possession of stolen property, methamphetamine, and for being under the influence of another controlled substance. Oh my goodness. May 14th, somebody brandished a deadly weapon in a threatening manner to two innocent passerbys in the 1,000 block. In the 1,000 block of the boulevard. May 15th, a 36-year-old man was arrested for committing grand theft possession of medication without a written prescription for it, and for being under the influence of a controlled substance in the 1,000 block of the boulevard. Oh my goodness. Okay. Well, Sheriff's Blotter, dated May 27th, May 10th. This is the Sheriff's Blotter I started yesterday, and then it got interrupted because I had a blooper. Everything fell, my coffee, my iPad, it was just Sheriff's Blotter, May 22nd, 2016. Okay, May 10th. The men's restroom of the kiddie park in the 1,000 block of such and such was vandalized between May 10th and May 18th. May 11th. About $4,100 in property was stolen from somebody's bedroom in the 1,000 block of the boulevard between May 11th and May 18th. A 29-year-old man was arrested for petty theft in the 900 block of boulevard May 12th. Two men distracted a female driver and stole $1,000 in property from her vehicle. May 13th, up to $1,000 in property were stolen from two cars in the 1500 block of such and such street between May 13th and 14th. A 36-year-old woman was arrested for child endangerment in the 200 block east, such and such. May 14th, about $2,000 in property was stolen from an unlocked vehicle in the 100 block of such and such a street. A man, age 20, was arrested on outstanding warrant in the 1300 block of the boulevard. A wallet was stolen in the 900 block of the boulevard after a man accidentally left it in the store. A 40-year-old man was arrested on four outstanding warrants in the 900 block of West such and such a road. May 15th, a man, age 26, was arrested for trespassing and petty theft in the 200 block of such and such a boulevard. His male companion, age 34, was also arrested for violating his parole and for his petty theft charges. May 16th, a 41-year-old man was arrested on an outstanding warrant and for being under the influence of a controlled substance on the 100 block of the boulevard. A woman, age 49, was arrested for using her fists to batter her child, causing injury in the 5,000 block of Calle such and such. May 17th, a 35-year-old man was arrested on outstanding warrant in the 2,000 block of Via such and such. A woman, age 24, was arrested for conspiring to commit a crime, burglary, possessing burglary tools, and reckless driving to evade police at the intersection of such and such and such and such. Her male companion, age 24, was arrested for burglary, conspiring to commit a crime, possessing burglary tools, and providing false identification to a police officer. He was also arrested on outstanding warrants. May 18th, a bike was stolen in the 700 block of Calle such and such between May 18th and May 19th. A man, age 66, was arrested for grand theft in the first block of such and such street. Property was stolen from a locked car in the 300 block of Calle such and such. A bike valued at $200 was stolen from the first block of the boulevard. May 19th, a 56-year-old man was arrested for failing to register as a sex offender in the 3000 block of such and such a street. A man, age 28, was arrested for inflicting corporal injury in the 2000 block Pickwick Drive. A 61-year-old man was cited for criminal trespassing in the 100 block of the boulevard. A woman, age 43, was arrested for obstructing a police officer in the line of duty on 100 block of the boulevard. Between May 12th and May 20th, police reported arresting one person for driving without a license or on a suspended license during that time. Also, during the same time period, one person was arrested for driving under the influence of a controlled substance, and 16 people were arrested on various drug charges. Oh my goodness. Well, let's skim, since I have time left over, let's go. And such was charged with two felony counts. Couple lose their home and their health to a fire. Both undergoing burn treatment with no place to live. There's an ad, urban home furniture. I like to skim the headlines and the ads. Do you guys like that? It's just relaxing for me. I like it. Such and such wants to pay it forward if she wins the county seat. And the candidate is backed by the county Democrats. Wine, Food, and Brew Festival 2016, June 5th at the Channel Islands University. That looks like fun. IRS problems are resolved. Call me. I'm a former IRS agent. A Fiesta leader asks for the support of the community. Here's an editorial in observance of Memorial Day. Long-time small business owner wants to make a difference. He's also been a council member for 19 years. Luxury river cruises in Europe. That'd be fun. The Enchanting Rhine. Melodies of the Danube. Oh, that'd be fun. Let's see. Mattress tent sale. Up to 70% off. Free hot dogs and drinks. Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and Monday. Memorial Day weekend. While supplies last. CHP says the actress may have been DUI. What actress is that? An actress on the Young and the Reds list. A local man is still in the hospital. Who is the actress? They were taken to Santa Barbara. Oh my goodness, I used to live right around the corner on West Winnipero Street. Like a few feet from the Cottage Hospital, Santa Barbara. Who is the actress? Our principal for all seasons says farewell. Elementary school principal is retiring. I don't know what I like better, the ads or the headline. Memorial Day ceremony at the mortuary. Oh, at the Memorial Park. Police is keeping tight tabs on local offenders. That's good. Here's an ad for Sleep Shop. Memorial Day event. When they have a Dean's List. Leg pain. symptoms for leg pain. A workshop on fundraising offered next month for fundraising techniques and strategies. Club gives a university a scholarship. Use vacation time to recharge and restore balance. Fewer than half of Americans take days off for R&R. That is true. We do need time off, vacation time to do nothing. Restore balance, reflect on who you are, reconnect with your friends, reinvigorate your life, and reaffirm where you're going. Need a spa cover, hydro spa. Here's another mattress. Annual Memorial Day parking lot sale. We pay your sales tax. 4 days only. Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and Monday for Memorial Day. Financing available. San Miguel Island reopens to the public. Toy Frog retires after a run-in with a crow. Dermatique. Join us for a special Botox Cosmetic and Juvederm Day. June 1st. 3 to 6 p.m. at Westlake Village. Botox, $12 a unit. A must-see exhibition now opens. Vatican Splendors, a journey through faith and art at the Reagan Library. Oh, I love the Reagan Library. In Simi Valley. Oh my goodness. Our whole family loves the Reagan Library. Okay. Dental implants. Smile with confidence. Now only $900 for one tooth. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Everyone deserves to live pain-free. Pain relief with whole body wellness. So, now hiring part-time, flexible hours, social services, respite care, foster respite. $12 to $16 an hour. Well, this has been fun. Columnist goes bananas in grocery store. Well, pet tips from the veterinary medical center.